students, good morning everyone. So in our previous classes, we have started a problem on double sampling plan. And we are continuing that problem even today. It's a lengthy problem, right? So 2 bits of an inch, that is at P equals to 0.01 and P equals to 0.02. Today we'll continue with the third bit. So coming to the third bit, what is the fraction defective? P equals to 3%, that is equals to 0.03. So if anyone of you missed the last classes or did not understand the last classes, how we have calculated the probabilities, so I am repeating today also with the third bit. Only thing is P value will be changing. So if you didn't understand the last classes, just listen it carefully. If you listen 2-3 times, you will understand the problem. So first we are going to find the PA value, that is probability of acceptance, which is equals to PA1 plus PA2. So what is PA1 value? PA1 equals to P of G1, which is given as P of G1, and it is equals to summation D1 equals to 0 to C1 N1 CD1 P power D1 1 minus P power N1 minus D1. Now first we will find PA1 value, so which is equals to PA1 equals to summation over D1 equals to 0 to, what is the C1 value given? 0, 100, N1 value is 100, C, D1, P value, P, in the third bit, the fraction effective P value is 0.03. So 0.03 into 1 minus 0.03 is 0.97 into, sorry, power N1 minus D1, that is 100 minus D1. So summation ranging from D1 equals to 0 to 0. That means D1 equals to only 0. So PA1 is equals to 100 C. D1 is 0, 0.03 power D1, right? So D1 value is 0 into 0.97 power 100 minus 0. So calculate the value. So that is 100 C, 0 is 100 into 0.03 power 0 is 1 into 0.97 power 100 minus 0, 100. So you will be getting the PA1 value as 0.0476. Now we have to find the PA2 value. So for OC curve we want PA value. So for that we are finding PA1 and PA2 values. So what is PA2? So PA2 equals to, we have the formula PA2 equals to summation over ranging from D1 equals to 0 to C2 minus D1. So D1 equals to 0 to C2 minus D1 means C2 value is 2. 2 minus D1 summation over D1 equals to C1 plus 1 to C2 into P of D1 into P of D2 given D1. So for different values of D1, we got the D2 and D1 values. So first, if D1 equals to 1, what are different values of D1? Yes, if D1 equals to 1 and 2, right? So if D1 equals to 1, we got D2 equals to 0, 1. So if D1 equals to 2, we got it as D2 equals to 0. Since D1 plus D2 should not be greater than C2, that is 2. So you have to remember this condition, then you can find these values easily. Now in double summation over this, this can be written as first D1 equals to 1, right? So probability of D1 equals to 1 into P of D1 into P of D2 given D1. So probability of D2 equals to, so if D1 equals to 1, D2 equals equals to 1 given d1 equals to 1 plus next d1 value is 2. So you will write p of d2 equals to 2 into p of d2 equals to 2 given d1 equals to 2 into p of d2 equals to 0. So at d1 equals to 2, d2 value we got 0 given d1 equals to 2. Now we know p of d1 formula. What is p of d1 formula? This one we have p of d1. What is p of d2 given? P of d2 given d1. So this can be written as p of d2 given d1 is given as n2 c d2 p power d2 1 minus p power n2 minus d2. So I am writing clearly everything in this way. If you find any confusion in the last bits, you can understand it here clearly. And so now, first we are finding pa2. So pa2 equals to first p of d1 equals to 1. So that means we will use this formula. So only 0 value it takes. So d1 equals to 1, right? So this can be written as 100c d1 equals to 1. We are going to write nc n1c d1. So 100c 1 into what is the p value? 0.03 power 1 into 1 minus 0.03 is 0.97 power n1 minus d1, that is 100 minus 1. So this is the first value. Next plus at d1 equals to 1, d2 equals to 1. So first this value as it is p of d1 equals to 1, that is 100c1. Oh, I have written only the first one, p of d1. After that p of d2 given d1. So what, by using this formula, so into d2 value is 0. So you will get n2c d2. 100c d2 value is 0. P value is 0.03. Power d2, d2 value is 0. 1 minus p is 0.97 power n2 minus d2, that is 100 minus d2 value is 0. This is the first term, that is p of d1 equals to 0 plus p of d1 equals to 0 into p of d2 equals to 0 given d1 equals to 1. Now the second term, this term we are going to write plus first p of d1 equals to 1. So p of d1 equals to 1, this value is as it is. So you write down the value as it is.
Place of 1 you write 2, so that is 100c2
we will get p a 2 value. Solve all the terms carefully. Do each term separately and add those three terms to get p a 2 value. So that we will be getting the p a 2 value as 0.0394.
PR1 equals to 0.5.
37.23. So if you observe, as the P values increases, the PA value is also decreasing. Similarly, ASN value is also decreasing. AOQ value is also decreasing. So this is the AOQ value we got, and this is the ASN value we got, and PA value is, we have PA equals to 0.0870. These are the three values you need to note down from the third bit. Now we will see the fourth bit. So coming to the fourth bit, at P equals to 7%. So solve it, we'll get PA2 value as 0.00004. So here if you observe, PA2 value equals to 0.00004. So 0.00004, even if you round off, approximately this value 0.0007, it is not 007, sorry, 0.0007. Here also 0.0007. Now we got the PA value. Now we have to find the AOQ and ASN values.
Right?
yes, 0.0007 plus PR1 value, we have done 0.9742. So from this, P1 value is equals to, add those two values, we will get P1 equals to 0.9749. Now we got P1 value. Substitute this P1 value in ASN. What is the ASN formula? ASN equals to N1, that is 100 plus N2. 100 into 1 minus P1. P1 value is 0.9749. Now substitute the value. We will be getting the answer as ASN equals to 102.51. ASN equals to 102.51. And what is the AOQ value we got? AOQ equals to 0. And what is the PA value we got? PA value we got it as 0.0007. So these three values note down for the fourth bit. So for fourth bit, these are the different values of the P equals to 0.07. So in the next class, we are going to find the probabilities at P equals to 0.10. If you understand this, try to do that bit. Along with that, we have to plot the graphs also. So we will be plotting AOC curve, AOQ curves. So for OC curve, we will be using PA values. For AOQ curve, we will be using AOQ values. And we will also plot the ASN curve also. For single sampling plan, we did not plot ASN, right? So here we will plot ASN also. Yes, we have done ASN also. Here also we will do ASN plot. So by plotting all those values, we will be getting the different graphs. From that we will find the AOQL value. The maximum value of AOQ is considered as the AOQL value. So hope you are understanding this problem. Try to do the fifth bit, that is at P equals to 10%, that is 0.10. We will do the graphs in the fifth bit in the next class. So by that, the problem will be completed for the double sampling plan.